Pretty good, I think.
I saw him yesterday. He told me a joke, and I said, "Is it cool with you?" And he said, "No," so I will tell you.
Dennis LeBlanc?
Yeah. Malcolm.
Two.
To the gorilla cadence, and they get to fooling around and dancing around and showing off their wares. And the gorilla gets very excited, you know, and pretty soon he gets a big erection. Pretty soon he can't stand it anymore. He tears the bars apart, and he reaches out and grabs one of the girls and yanks her in, and he screws the hell out of her. And then he picks her up and throws her against the wall and decides he hasn't had enough to go over and screws the hell out of her again. And finally the guards and the keepers get there and drag him off and take her to the hospital. And she's in terrible shape. And for 3 days they don't...
He doesn't write, he doesn't call, he doesn't send flowers.
Sorry, none of you were paying any attention. When Jim Baker and Don and I entered, we thought that you'd notice that we're all wearing our sincere blue suits. Sorry, I'm out of character.
Cemetery is great down here.
I understand that their senator's talking budget up on the hill, so we've got some empty chairs here that they get filled before the morning's over. And I know everybody's looking forward to the Easter recess, but we've also got a lot of issues facing us when we get back. Before getting to anything else, I want to once again thank you all for your support on the MX missile fight. It was a big victory, and I appreciate what you did to help. Now, our principal agenda is budget, but I wanted Jim Baker to have a few minutes to update you on the progress and timetable for our tax reform legislation. Jim?
Well, Mr. President, as many here probably know, I've spent the better part of the 8 weeks I've been over at the department working on tax reform, and we've had any number of meetings with the congressional leadership, with congressional authors of plans, and more meetings than I like to think about with public interest groups who have some complaint about some aspect or another of the Treasury proposal. I think we've had two sessions with John Duncan and the Republican members on Ways and Means. We've had two or three sessions with Bob Packwood. We've had some meetings with Bradley and Gephardt, Jack Kemp and Bob Caston, and we've had some meetings with members of the Senate Finance Committee. As far as the timetable is concerned, we're looking at the end of this month or the first part of next month to launch the effort, and that's going to be determined largely by how successful we are in terms of the budget in the Senate. We also have a constraint that's imposed by the fact that you're going to be going to the summit the first 6 or 7 days in May. So we've got to make a determination with respect to whether or not we try and go before the summit or after the summit, and that's largely going to be determined by the progress we make on the budget.
Secretary General Daniel Lord Carrying.
Thank you very much.
Ambassador Absher,
Mr. President, good to see you today.
Paul, Chief Deputy Navy, Secretary General. Jason Grossman, the Deputy Secretary.
Peter?
How are you?
Nice to see you again.
Seen you for a while.
Well, I'm just delighted. Just thought I'd be a fly on the wall and hear what you all have to say.
George,
good to see you today.
These chairs.
Here.
Thank you for so many things.
I'm gonna hear better.
Yeah, I think it went well. Took a while.
Well, we've been waiting on the lines. Well, we've had some success. We've gone to the bottom of the line.
As always.
But this song didn't.
That's fine. Can't sit around.
No, that's too bad.
Very self-conscious about it.
I love the show.
Years ago, I went to a dinner.
George?
I think I was Speaker at home. So it's 40 years ago. Some curbstone politician, you know, that I didn't even know. I got up when I was off. Curley came back and he said, you got a great career in politics, he said. Never go unprepared. He said, you were completely unprepared tonight. So I want you to come over to my house, he said, Friday morning. I'm going to give you 10 pieces that I want you to learn. If you learn these pieces, you always can get up and recite a piece of a poem, he said, that'll take you out of the embarrassment that you're in. So I had the 10 pieces, and that was one of them. Then he had one, Around the Car, I Have a Friend in This Great City That Has No End, The Days Go By and the Weeks Roll On. Then he had Never a Borrower Lend to Be. He had 10 of them. You know, get a couple of pops in me, I can remember them all.
Exploited children is a major issue, I believe, in America today. A problem that can threaten every American family, rich or poor. The possibility of a kidnapping or abuse to a child is one of the major fears that I think parents now face. So each of you are here today because you're integrally involved in the missing and exploited children issue. Just last May, we launched the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children to help address part of this issue. I know with success, and I'm pleased to see so many of these board members, of, along with the directors here today. They have set up, among other things, a hotline where people can call in instantly, and as I understand it, they've been getting about 225 calls a day. Many of you here represent other major efforts, public and private, that can address these critical problems, but there's much more to be done, and I know that you've discussed ways of doing more. So I'm asking you today to form a new partnership for child safety. And this partnership can involve law enforcement organizations, school systems, community service groups in coordination with the Attorney General and his offices at the Department of Justice. And I'd like to ask if you could report back to me in 3 weeks' time with your recommendations of how such a partnership should be structured. And I'll let you keep track of the calendar on this. And it's my hope that this partnership can be launched so that every child in the country will have the opportunity to be safe and secure. And you're the people who will make it work. And you have my heartfelt thanks for what you're doing and what you continue to do. Now I understand we have a brief pause.
Mr. President, Senator Dole says the budget is going to be a hard sell. What are you going to do to help sell it? Let's compromise.
I always do, sell.
Is it going to be tough?
Isn't it always so?
And Mr. President, I'm sure that everyone here is most appreciative of this opportunity to share a few moments with you. We've had some very fruitful discussions this morning and then again this afternoon, and we've gone over the areas that you've already discussed, and the need for a partnership is very clear to all of us. And I think that we have already done a lot of work in getting the groundwork ready for such a partnership between the federal government and state and local, and with the private sector. I think that there's an enormous amount of good that can be done. What I think would be the best thing we might be able to do in these moments is to just briefly go around and see some of the perspectives of what we can and what we think we can do.
All right. Good to see you.
Great.
Hi. How are you?
Hi, Mr. President.
Hello, George.
Hi, sir.
Nice to see you.
Hi,
nice to see you.
Nice
to see
you. We seem to have a little fuss brewing here, but it has to do with the hill, not us.
Oh. That's a temporary late.
Well, I'm sure that Yasu understands that. We've been getting along very well with him. We're delighted to hear your views on this thing. I have to say that there's one little corner of me down inside that says that maybe the hill getting so rambunctious will be helpful and helpful to him and what he's trying to do.
It will bring home, I think, the opposition and the obstructionism which he faces in this country. I use the words deliberately because most of the brouhaha is emotional, and not based on facts, not based on the figures, but based on a particular country, which I think is very poor psychology and will tend to weaken what I think, as you referred to yourself most often as well as Secretary Shultz, the most important bilateral relationship in the world, bar none. They don't seem to recognize that Nakasone is the head of the weakest element within the LDP, that he has been dependent on Tanaka for his survival, and it's created problems. He's had to walk a delicate line. They also have to be aware of the fact that, as you pointed out, he faces political problems like you do, which he has to cope with and consider.